Oh, the fender.
E36. Let me show you some stuff that is worn out. First things first, you can see that the spring is broken. And it's completely stock. So we're gonna do some upgrading. Let's go up with it. All right, we're gonna show you how worn out this bushing is. Let me get my pry bar. Put the light on it. See that movement? That's worn out. So we're gonna put some stock bars. I mean, stock bush. What am I saying? Aftermarket polyurethane bushings. Look at that. No bueno. New springs, new shocks, all new diff bushings we'll be putting in this thing. It's all stock. It's got build seams in there, but going over bumps, this rear end feels so loose. So let's get to it. Look at the swivel socket. Smoking. All right, me and my buddy Mark, you saw there, just took the exhaust down. Now we are going to pull the emergency cables out. I don't know if I'm gonna snake them all the way out, but I'm gonna take the rotors and calipers off and then remove the calipers, snake the brake lines out of the way, and then take the drive shaft off and we'll go from there. I'm gonna take everything out as an assembly. Stay tuned.
girl, she work the pole, she break it down, she take it low, she fine as hell, she bout the dough, she doing a thing out on the floor. Her money, money, she make it, look at the way she shake it, make you wanna touch it, make you wanna taste it. How you lustin' for it, going crazy, face it now, don't stop, get it. The way she shake it, make you wanna hit it. Then she double joint it from the way she split it. Got your head fucked up from the way she did it. She's so much more than you used to. She knows just how to move to seduce you. She gon' do the right thing and touch the right spots and dance on your lap till you're ready to pop. She always ready when you want it. She want it like a nympho, the info. I show you where to meet her on the late night till daylight. The club jumping if you want a good time. She gon' give you what you want.
All right, next thing is we're going to be welding in the reinforcement plate. As you can see, I'm having the bolt hold in place the plate, this one too. It's already nice and snug, but first I'm going to take it back off and grind all this down, right down to bare metal. And then I'll put a bolt to hold it in place and weld it up. I'll cover something up, cover the gas tank obviously, so any sparks I don't want to catch on fire. See how that works, perfect fit. I'll screw that up tight so it's snug and weld it up, and then once that's done we'll start attacking the bushings and whatnot. So I just prepped the plates to weld up. I'll show you what I did over here. Did those two. And I'm gonna weld them up. It in. That. That's how you get them in. Or get them out, I should say. I am now going to be doing the differential bushings. So I'm going to pull the diff out and take the axles out and then do the bolt, slip it out so I can pop these bushings in, and then we'll do the trailing arms after. We'll be right back. Alright, I already took out one of the diff bushings. Let me show you what I did. This is Brad eating a sandwich, by the way. So I put a press like that, just put a socket. You gotta be careful because it's aluminum. Move your hand, Brad, for a second. I already took the other one out. Alright, put it back there. He's being my holder. There we go. As you can see, this one's really worn out. That's why I felt like the rear end was all over the place. Bushings out. I'm gonna take it out to the power washer, power wash the whole subframe, and hit it with some black paint so it looks nice. And also paint the diff, let it dry, and then put the bushings in. Make sure you have a well ventilated shop to smoke like that. Alright, I'm gonna throw some paint on the rear end of the subframe. I got this Rust-Oleum enamel. Bonds the metal, and it acts like a primer too. I think I just do it black. Let that dry for a few minutes and I'll do another coat to flip it upside down to the other knee. Alright, I'm about to put the diff bushings, the front diff bushings in. I just cleaned the holes up with sandpaper. Get rid of all the paint and corrosion. And now I'm going to put a little handy seize on these. I always put handy seize in them. Prevent squeaking and they go in easier. Way easier. Definitely wear gloves in this one. Make sure you have a pink rag to wipe your hands off. And you have a rubber mallet. Tight. Ain't that a bitch? I just cracked the cover. Ain't that a bitch? So as you saw, I did a rookie move. I should have heated up the housing a little bit and tapped it in with a little heat on it. It's the aluminum. But I went a little too crazy with the hammer and cracked it and then finished it off, trying to take the new bushing out. Luckily, I have a spare cover and rear end. I'm just gonna steal it. Oops, I should have known better, but whatever. I've done a million of these and it was going in a little too high. But hey, live you learn, I guess. Me and Brad brought the subframe over here, got it on jack stands. Say what's up, Brad. Say what's up.
What's up?
Put some undercoating, obviously. Got the bolt screwed on. We're gonna lower it on there. Brad, you wanna lower the lift for me? Zip them up.
Whoa. Whoop. That worked all up. That's okay.
All right, now, everything, I can start putting it back together now. All right, guys, I jumped ahead here and didn't want to video every little step. I just wanted to get it done, it was late. So I went ahead and installed the diff. Obviously I painted it green because I just felt like it. I was gonna do black, but I'm like, you know, why not do green like the knuckles? So everything's tied to the springs and coils. I'm actually gonna show you how I set the preload. It's a little bit different than the front coilover. So Jordan, you wanna lower it a little bit? I got a couple of camera guys too.
Oh, the girls are here.
You're on YouTube, say hi. Go a little bit more, Jordan. So, keep going, Jordan, a little bit more. So when you set the preload, all right, that's good, bud. You set the height with this ring right here first, and then you set the preload with this ring. So same thing, you make sure it's snug, you bring it up, set the height, and then you loosen this up and use this wrench again and turn this to 5 millimeters, kind of like the front. It's kind of hard to explain right now, but because I already tightened and set it. So I'm going to put the wheels on and we're going to go test drive it. That's it.
Pop a battle.